All right, y'all, I'm about to board. So I will catch y'all when I hit Miami. Here goes my airport buffet. Comfy for a little bit. Comfy cute. Of course, you can never go wrong by adding in a little rip jacket. All right, I just landed in Miami. I believe Detroit and Miami are on the same time zone. It's 1:17 a.m. because my flight was slightly delayed, like 30 minutes. My driver has already called to let me know that they are here. They actually called 3 times. They were actually about to leave, but luckily I saw that I had 3 missed calls once I got here. And he said he was about to turn around, so that's good. So I'm headed to baggage claim to get my baggage. Hey y'all, so I'm sitting in here at Seduction Cosmetics. I finally finished the pre-op paperwork. I'm currently sitting in the back room where they just took pictures of me. It was a little bit more paperwork to fill out back here where they're just going over the contract, making sure everything's okay. Here's a note to add: any card that you use to pay for your procedure, they want you to actually physically have it or have a picture of it, or print out your, you know, pull up your bank statement so, you know, they can have proof of that, which is weird because they have you add in a photocopy of it every single time you make a payment, but whatever. That's just a little note to add. They just did my COVID test, so I'm just sitting here waiting on that, praying that that's negative, because I have been sitting here feeling a little bit of sniffles. I'm actually in pre-op, but I wore a robe because my one of the dolls at my recovery home was stating that she was a pre-op the day before and it was freezing, so I had like a jean jacket and she was like, girl, take your robe, and I'm gonna take it from her. And I did, and I brought it, and I'm so thankful I brought it because my pre-op started, I got here late. My recovery house obviously is doing all my transportation and things like that. But according to them, they're like, you know, pre-op doesn't really matter if they give you a time, as long as you get there before mid or before like noon or afternoon. Girl, y'all, my lashes is falling. I'm so tired. I ain't put enough glue on them, but luckily I brought a little stick of glue, so I'm gonna just fix those things. But anyway, so they got me here like 10:15 or something like that, because there was a lot of traffic, stuff like that, which was no biggie. I came right in, they came, gave my paperwork, and I sat down and started. They didn't even pull me to the back until like I was doing my paperwork in the lobby. I didn't actually come to the back until I think my watch died. It's like, it's at least afternoon now. It's like 12:30 or something. And I've been in this room. Well, after getting back, I had to sit in another hallway for a little bit before they called me into this room. I only sat in that hallway maybe for like 20, 30 minutes though. And now I'm in this room. Like I said, we did some pictures. We went over some little final paperwork. I'm trying to decide if I'm gonna add in, I wanted my brow rolls done at least, but just for that alone, that's $900, and it's not even the area that I want. It's like the side of the bra roll. Like, it's not even the back fat, upper back. They said that's more, so I'm trying to see what that cost is, because I'm already over here scraping by trying to even figure that out. If I can't get what I want done, then I'm just not going to get it, because I don't want to waste the money. So I'm just highly annoyed. This is not how I wanted this to go. I had this planned out for a while now. This was a gift to myself after having so many children, and especially having my last two kids after having my surgery. This was a really a gift to myself to get my body back how I wanted it. And unfortunately, an unforeseen circumstance happened. I ended up having to leave my home with my children, and so that was a lot of money that was spent to relocate. And then other expenses happened, and so my finances dwindled down. I paid for my tummy tuck. I couldn't get my breast reduction. And then unfortunately, once you sign those contracts, you can't. Once you so I'll come back to you guys. Give me a moment. Come back to y'all because I had to still go through some stuff. I had to still take my drug test. I had to do my COVID swab. Or did I do my COVID swab prior to? I think I had already did my COVID swab, but when she had came back, I had to do my drug test and all of that other stuff. So anywho, what I was saying is, once you sign that surgical contract and you put your deposit down, they don't allow you to transfer that deposit to anything. So I have a deposit down on my breast reduction. I have a deposit down on my Lipo 360. I can't use it. That's like $800 worth of stuff I just can't do anything with right now, because I'm gonna have to get the Lipo 360 or and the breast reduction if I want to recuperate any of that money. Otherwise, I just gave them rich surgeons $800 for nothing. So another thing that I want you guys to be very, very mindful of, please, please be very, very mindful. So I never heard of a mandatory post-operative package. And I will take pictures and I will upload it. But as far as now, just discussing it with you guys, they just charged me $720 that I knew nothing about. Because I was going to, because I'm in-house now, they were going to let me do my upper back for $1,000. And that's what I was going to do. I just wasn't going to get no massages while I'm here. I'm a nurse. I have a med spa. I would have just did the bare minimum massage that I could do while I'm here. Or I could have just got some money from my stepfather. A few hundred dollars to get a few massages while I'm here. Which, actually, I just reached out to him. He's going to send me a few dollars. So I'll, get a massage for my tummy tuck or whatever. I don't know. But, this package here was $720, all sales final. I was told that it was mandatory, but when I just read my contract over, it said that it was if you choose to purchase the pre-operative or post-operative package. So, and I just found out those people run off commission, so she probably lied to me. So tomorrow I'm definitely going to address that and hope that I can get some of that money back, because I was going to spend that money towards my back lipo. So I could have at least gotten my upper back done, because I'm super, super insecure about it right now. So anywho, this package includes one SCC medication package. So your antibiotics, or surgery cosmetic center, I guess is what it fucking stands for. Antibiotics, your nausea meds, and your painkillers. That was $102.55. Now mind you, I could have went to the pharmacy and got the shit for like $35 total. The one POP. So I'm gonna assume that's one post-op tummy tuck post-op package. Includes one binder, one body garment, two drug tests, three Lovenox if necessary by surgeon. That was $321. Then one Scanuva 30 grams. That was $96.30. One COVID-19 test, $100. And then of course the payments towards my surgery that I paid for in cash, which was 321, 321. 196. Oh, yeah, that's how they broke it down. They were just showing that I paid for this $720 in cash. Yeah, so apparently this here is supposedly mandatory. She was telling me that if I didn't purchase the package, I couldn't go into my surgery. They won't allow me to get the surgery without it. But like I said, I just looked over my old contracts and it said, if you choose to purchase. So just be mindful when you come down here, if you choose to come to this surgical center, to make sure that you have some extra money, because Lord knows I would have been devastated if I got down here, didn't have the money for that package, and couldn't get my surgery done. Because I mean, I've already paid for a recovery house, I've already paid for a flight, I've already taken time off work. So, you know, that would have been some bullshit. And of course, they don't let you get your money back from the surgery, they would just reschedule you. And it's like, that's a huge inconvenience when I've already had to do all of the work to just make this work, especially as a mom of six and a nurse, meaning I'm always at work. So no, you know, that took a lot of getting babysitters together, figuring out, you know, getting the food situation together, making sure that, you know, my kids have stuff for food when they're away, or money for food when they're away, and money at the house when, you know, they keep them at my house. So, you know, a lot of coordination went into me being able to come down here. So that would have been a super inconvenience. So make sure y'all be on y'all P's and Q's, and make sure you ask more questions. And even if you don't come to the cosmetic center I'm at and you go somewhere else, just ask, is there any type of any type of hidden fees that I'm gonna find out when I get there that'll accrue, just because you want to make sure you have that extra money. So yeah. Okay, with that being said, I'll update you guys more throughout the day. Today is just my pre-op day. So this is actually full day of me being at the recovery house. I got here at like 1 something or 2 something in the morning. My flight was like 30 minutes delayed, so I didn't even get here until like 1 or 2 something in the morning. So when I got here, you know, they had to put me in the wrong room, which I understood because somebody had a late checkout, so they wanted to make sure that they could clean and sterilize my room prior to me being in it. And you know, everybody was tired, it was 2 something in the morning, so they just put me in another room, you know, which was fine. I completely understood that. You know, gotta be accommodating, because you know, in a situation, all type of things can happen. So, you know, I understood. They were great about it. And then when I came back from my pre-op, my room was clean, it was sterilized, and it was ready for me. So, you know, it is what it is. Very accommodating. I've had 2 meals so far. I've had breakfast, which was like a homemade, not McGriddle, like a homemade English muffin sandwich. It was good. With some fresh fruit and apple juice. And then for lunch, I had a sandwich, some chips, and some Milano chocolate cookies, and I love those. So, and apple juice again. So yeah, so far so good. It's really quiet around here. I can say that it's very relaxing. I can see it's going to be very conducive to the healing environment. The owner, she's very sweet. Very accommodating. She heard how I was upset about the package I knew nothing about. She actually came out to the pool, you know, had a discussion with me, and you know, just to check on me. So that was very nice of her. But yeah, so far so good. I can't wait for dinner. I've been smelling the food. I forgot the lady's name. She's been in the kitchen cooking all day to prepare dinner. So I'm sure it'll be good. I've been taking pictures of the food, so I'll be posting those in like a longer vlog, or like, you know, snippets of things when I put everything together. But I kind of want to update you guys day by day, how I did with my prior surgery, just so you guys can be and feel more involved. So I'll probably take some pictures of dinner, and I'll do some footage maybe poolside. Today's just gonna be a relaxing day, because like I said, haven't had surgery, so nothing too much going on. I'm here by myself, as far as like, I don't have any friends here, so yeah, that part probably won't be so entertaining, but I will update you and give you as much education as I can. And then I'll also educate you guys or update you guys on other aspects of my life. I saw a few of you asking about an update on marriage. I saw a few of you asking about, you know, how the kids were, how the hubby was, things of that nature. So we'll update, but just a quick, you know. Actually, I actually saw him in my comments stating that he had messed up and he misses me and the kids, and he's sorry for hurting me. So And he also commented back to someone and said, we're not together anymore. So yeah, I don't know if you guys read that comment, but I actually saw it as I was hearting you guys' comments back. So yes, there's no ring on my finger anymore. We are separated. I have filed for divorce. So that's just ripping off the band-aid. I don't know. Yeah, just ripping off the band-aid. But yeah, so I'll get into more details with that type of stuff, like family updates and, you know, education and business wise and all that stuff too while I'm here. So I'll probably talk to you guys like that poolside. But right now I'm just gonna probably take a nap. I didn't get much sleep. And then I'll go poolside a little bit later. So see you guys in a little bit. There's little call lights in the room. This is the decor. This is my bed. My half of the room. I got a split bedroom. I love this. So yeah, this is my half of the room. How cute is that? Here I go, y'all. This is literally my last time with this mommy gut. So I'm 6 kids in. Okay, the glass could have been a little bit better. Okay, let's try this side. Okay, whatever. So 6 kids in. This is it. This is the mommy pooch that I can't wait to get rid of. All of this looks like I'm still 6 months pregnant with a little girl because of how high I sit up. So my abs are actually separated at the top. Hold on, let me pause this TV. All right, sorry y'all. So my abs are actually separated at the top. So that's why my stomach sits up so high, like I'm 6 months pregnant instead of sitting low. Like if people who have ab separation at the bottom, their pooch sits out like in this area. You see where mine like dips in? Theirs sits here. Mine dips in and then it goes round because my abs are separated mostly at the top. Like I damn near need to zip it up. So the thing about it is, it's crazy. So although my abs are separated, I have regained muscle control, meaning I can actually make my stomach flat so people don't know that it's fat. So watch this. Okay, hold on y'all. And I actually could walk around this like this all day. No one ever knows, but here we go. So this is no sucking it in. Look how big it is. Look how big. I literally look like I'm 6 months to 8 months pregnant. That's no sucking it in. That's insane, right? Watch this. So I literally can walk around like this all day and look fire. All day. I can walk around, I can breathe normally, I can
I can do all of that. But that's not real, okay? This is the real girl. Shameful. Shameful. All because I had 6 kids. They separated my abs completely. Mostly my last 2. I would give it to them. Ain't no way I look pregnant from the front and the back, and I'm nowhere near pregnant. That is insane. Look at this, y'all. Look at this. Who wants to walk around like this every day? Do you know how often I'll be asked, how many months are you? How many months? And I have to say, I'm not pregnant. But because my abs are so separated, they have pushed all of my fat, my organs, everything. And this is it. But no one ever knows because I walk around like this. Every day, all day. This is how I walk around. Y'all, we gotta do better. The good Lord needs to bless us with the zipper. But since he did not, it's cool. He did bless the surgeons that are gonna work on me, and they're gonna zip this bad boy back on up, because that ain't hot. That look was not hot, and I'm tired of it.
All right, y'all, so I have finally come outside, back outside to the pool area. I'm in the jacuzzi part. The pool is over there. The pool is warm too. I thought the pool probably would have been cold, but it's not. They're both warm. I'm just out here chilling. I was just actually on the phone talking to a few people back home. My brother's so funny. He literally just checked my location and he just called me like, "You in Miami?" I'm like, "Yeah." He's like, "So you wasn't gonna call? You wasn't gonna say nothing to nobody? You got my location, bud." You know, type shit. So, yeah. Well, I'm out here. I'm enjoying the quiet, the calm. Somebody just walked out, the next door neighbor, but yeah, the quiet and the calm. This is a full-blown gated community, and I don't just mean any gated community. I mean the type of gated community where you're damn near on your own island type of community. Okay, so when we pulled up, I'm used to like gated communities where, you know, the gate opens and you lead pretty much into like a long circular driveway to the front of the house. No, boo boo. This gated community is where there's a security guard at the gate and there's somebody else at the gate, and there's a whole little office for them to sit into at the gate, and you have to not only tell them your name but the address you're going to, as well as they have to scan the back of your license. That type of gated community, okay? So needless to say, this is a very nice nice place. I don't know how many rooms there are. Like I said, I had initially got here, like I said, around 2 a.m., 2:30 a.m., maybe 2:40 for real, for real. And it was really quiet. Everybody was asleep. So, you know, they had me in the wrong room, but I didn't mind because I didn't want to make a big fuss or wake everybody up. But right now I'm in my room, and it is just where there's 2 of us, but there's no one else in there so far. I don't know if someone else is coming tonight or tomorrow, but as of now, it was just me. I did take obviously a video that you're probably gonna see prior to this part, a snippet of me in the room, showing you guys my room, things of that nature. Let's say I'm on the upstairs level, so that may be kind of difficult once I get my surgery, because I'm gonna be having to take the stairs. I probably won't take the stairs the first night or two. I might sleep in the living room where there's some recliners and stuff like that, but eventually I do want to start taking the stairs up to my room. If I'm paying for a room, I won't sleep in it. Yes, I just finished eating dinner not too long ago. Dinner was bomb. Out of all the meals, dinner was bomb. I'd say the first meal of the day, it was good. It was good. It was cute, but it was, it's a sandwich and a breakfast sandwich. Even though it was handmade, you know, it was not just any old throw it in the microwave or oven type breakfast. It was made, so I'll give them that. The sandwich, I'm not really sure what kind of meat it was. It could have been chicken, it could have been turkey, don't know. But I devoured it because I hadn't eaten since breakfast, which was like at 7:30 or 8 o'clock in the morning, and I had been gone all up until damn near 2 o'clock in the afternoon, so I was hungry. So I ate it, demolished it. Was no issue, even though they could have gave your girl, like y'all gonna see in that picture inserted over here probably, some more chips. They gave me like the balled up chips at the bottom of the bag. but that was cool. Whatever, it is what it is. They did give me them cookies, which I love. I'm obsessed with those cookies. Now for dinner though, I'll insert a clip here. And dinner was fire. The macaroni was good. It was some type of cabbage. The cabbage had other little mixed vegetables thrown in with some sausages. I think it was like maybe smoked sausage or andouille. And then there was some cornbread, which was great. It was phenomenal. Everybody who know me know I'm a lover of cornbread. So ate that. It was some type of chicken, like baked or grilled chicken, but it was like spicy. And because I had my gallbladder removed in November, spicy food really just doesn't sit well with me. So I only took like 2-3 bites of the chicken and I stopped eating it. But there were like some chicken wings. You could tell like they were like maybe teriyaki some type of way. They had really good flavor, but yeah, no, can't do that for now. What else was on that plate? I ate it so fast, y'all. I was starving, okay? And dinner here is really early. It was like 5:30 when she started yelling through the house calling for dinner. So yeah, and then I think after that, we don't get anything else besides maybe snacks, unless you want to order something, but hell, for this price, I'm just gonna eat what they give me, okay? That was that. Also, they did not come pick me up from the recovery house. I mean, from the pre-op. What they did do, however, was send me an Uber, which was a nice Uber. And you know, obviously I got here, since they ordered it, they were able to see and track my location for safety purposes up until I got to the home. So that was a nice touch as well. Yeah, so I think I pretty much touched on everything so far that happened today. Like I said, today is just day one, but it's not day one of surgery or anything like that. It's pre-op. Oh, so boom. Here's an update that I have not shared with you guys yet because it just happened. So I just got a call that Dr. Abir, I think I'm saying her name right, had an opening. And you know, this is God. So y'all know how I was upset because I can't get my back lipo today and I'll have to wait 6 months to get it, because once you get surgery, they make you wait a minimum of 6 months before you can get anything else done for safety purposes, obviously. But I chose Dr. Alfred Sofer for one, because he's really good with breasts and I really wanted a breast reduction. You guys can see my boobs. They hang low. I want them sitting up and I want them smaller, and I can't do that because I breastfed 6 kids, so the skin is really loose. They hang. I want these boys up and perky, okay? So yeah, I wanted a breast reduction, and I chose him because his incisions around the nipples and underneath the breast are really, really good. His incisions are good. They call him the breast king. So I wanted him specifically for that purpose, because I feel like with boobs, they're a lot harder to hide. You know, I can get a freaking tattoo, not that I would, over my C-section scar. I mean, not C-section, my tummy tuck scar, which I possibly am. Maybe, maybe not, depending on how it heals. But for your breasts, it's kind of like, once they out, girl. You know what I'm saying? Once they can be seen, they are visible. It's, who's getting a tattoo over their whole entire boob or nipple? Or who am I doing that? Now, I have seen people with the tattoos that go in here and they go underneath. That's something good that I could do if, you know, I choose to go that route. But you know, and I love me a good tattoo, so I have nothing against tattoos. But you can't get tattoos right away after surgery because, you know, the ink either won't take or it'll mess something up. So yeah, surgery or tattoos are down the line. But anyway, I was upset about not being able to get my my back lipo, because y'all,
the girl got a back row galore.
Oh yeah, y'all see this tattoo. Anyway, y'all can see your girl got a little bit of body, a little bit of booty, but oh, see on the side, a little bit of a, you know, back row action that I don't want. Little tummy tuck, there's no need to nipple tuck this. You see how that skin moves? Yeah, I need all of that gone, because when I get in a bathing suit like this, I need to be, you know, flat. This is from my gallbladder coming out. But anyway, so what I was about to say to y'all. Oh, so most doctors, when you get a tummy tuck, they don't you have to pay additional for them to lipo the upper part of your stomach. I don't know, most people did not know this, so I'm going to educate. With a tummy tuck, it just includes, if you're paying for a full tummy tuck, the muscle repair and anything underneath the belly button, meaning they'll remove all of the stretch marks and the skin that are underneath the belly button. They'll all be gone. It'll be tightened, it'll be cute, it'll be taut like you want it. Everything above the belly button, however, like any scarring, any any stretch marks, anything like that will still be there. And you have to pay to get the lipo and stuff like that so that you can be sculpted. Because with the tummy tuck, they'll do like your sides. You know, this tummy tuck comes with two areas of lipo, but that's just, you know, either side to, you know, give you that sculpted look. But if you've ever seen somebody with like a bulgy upper portion to their stomach, it's because they didn't pay for the lipo. Anyway, long story short, Dr. Abir, so the reason that most doctors don't do it unless you pay for it is because there is a higher risk of loss to blood supply. But Dr. Abir studied in the DR and they taught her, that's how she learned to do it a different way so that you don't lose the blood supply. And get this, y'all, she doesn't charge additional for the upper stomach lipo. I'm gonna get that for free. Y'all, look at this ugly ass scar. That's a scar, y'all. It's not herpes. It's, I don't have no STDs, never have, never will. This is a scar. I know y'all not used to it. I know y'all ain't never seen it before. It's recent. I acquired this January 28th of 2024. So I've been putting Mederma on it. I'm hoping it'll go away. But as of now, your girl just be having to put Mederma on, cute little lip gloss, and, you know, try to hide it the best I can. I don't like it, but whatever it is, what it is. Yeah. So also, I have to go get my teeth done now, because as y'all can see, I have this wire that's not yellow stuff on my teeth. That is whatever they use to cure the teeth, or cure the wire onto the teeth. It's called a stent, and it holds everything in place. My jaw was fractured, so my teeth had dropped down a little bit. That's why I have such a huge gap, and one of the teeth, or two of the teeth, are sitting lower. I have to go get some veneers because they're no longer in the socket. They are, and there's nerve damage, severe nerve damage. All of the nerves on that side have been severed. I'll get into that in a different day. But anyway, I was just excited to let y'all know that even though I can't get my back lipo done today, I am going to be able to get the upper stomach lipo. So I'll be snatched from the front. From the back, I'm going to have to work out for 6 months and then come and get some surgery, because, yeah, can't get it done for 6 months anyway. So during the 6 months, I'll be working out so that my skin can be perfectly retracted when I'm ready to come get it. So yeah, and I might end up just getting that in Michigan or wherever I'm staying at that point, because I still want to move out of town, y'all. Still have determined to do that. I don't know if it's gonna be 25 or 26, year 25 or year 26, but that is still my goal. But anyway, yes, so I'm probably gonna be done updating you guys for today. This seems like it's gonna be a long enough video. This video portion is already 11 minutes 30 seconds long, so with all the little clips from earlier, this should have been a long enough video. I know it wasn't super entertaining, but I hope it was very educational. And I will see you guys tomorrow. I'm gonna update or upload this tonight so that I can be consistent with the uploads. I don't know how good I'll be tomorrow just because I'm gonna be in pain, but I promise you, ladies and gentlemen, if you're watching, I'll do my damnedest to try to give you a day one and still not only record but upload. If I don't have the energy to do all of that, I'll do snippets throughout the day, and then I'll just upload like a day one through day three or whatever the case may be. But I'll try and continue to be very consistent, because I love you guys, I miss you guys, and I'm ready for some more people to join the squad. Definitely ready for that. So with that being said, it's your girl, Always Nigeria, and Always Nigeria is out.